I spent my life as a glassblower, 38 years, until it closed in January 2009. And having been, I suppose, totally socialised into an industrial life and a trade union life, it was kind of a shock to find, wake up one morning and find you have nothing to do or no place to go. You go in sometimes into things thinking that everyone thinks the same as yourself, or if you're involved in, particularly if you're involved in movements that are somewhere radical. But the reality of it is there's a lot of talking to be done and a lot of understanding of people's positions.
The intention in terms of movements outside of the university was to create space for discussion, to learn from each other's struggles, and also to hopefully build alliances and, you know, do something exciting, something that excited the people on the course, you know, most of who, or nearly all of them, have both an activist and an academic background.
I joined the CEESA program in 2010. It was the first time the course ran, and a very, I suppose, exciting time in Irish politics. It was at the time when a lot of the IMF was starting to come in, the bondholders, all this stuff that was happening. I never would have had the time, growing up in a kind of up-class area, really, to really think deeply, you know what I mean? Because you're involved in politics and in campaigns, sometimes you just jump from campaign to campaign, from issue to issue, and sometimes you never actually had enough time to reflect.
It's very easy to get so involved kind of in an issue that you kind of continue with the same practices that, you know, maybe not aren't working anymore, and you don't know like why kind of you've come to a dead end, like in your particular campaign. And I think it's really valuable to like take a step back, like by doing this course, and reflect on kind of what's going on in other struggles, and kind of there's a huge idea of like learning from each other and other struggles.
I think one of the strengths of the course is that people are coming to a course designed by people with a background in adult education. So the idea that everyone comes in the door with the same dispositions, the same experience, and it's simply there to, you know, learn what the university has to present is not part of the way we design the course. So there's an openness to different ways of approaching learning, different ways of thinking about learning, different types of knowledge construction. And I think that's an advantage both to us in the course as a whole, but also to individual students who may not be coming from a traditional academic background.
The group environment like that you create within the course, like within the group, is so supportive, like, and that's very deliberate. Like,
the more I got to know about the CEESA course, the more I realised that well, I could practice my work anyway, and there was a real openness and support expressed by the lecturers in me kind of continuing with you know, arts-based research or art production the way I wanted to. But their course would definitely give me the kind of political education I wanted.
And first few days, maybe weeks even, people are still tiptoeing around, and thankfully the staff and the I suppose from ourselves as well, getting to know each other, we eventually created a lovely environment that was very welcoming, very open, and I must say, I think if you talk to anyone on that course, even to this day, everyone kind of could feel that they were heard or listened to or respected.
Yeah, I mean, I think the thing that works, in my opinion, and I think this is borne out by what students have to say as well, or ex-students, graduates, is that it's quite generative to spend time really discussing things, you know, really creating space for dialogue.
There were lots of incidences in the course kind of like that where I didn't know what to expect about a particular module or a particular class, and you know, I had a preconception about it, and I think that the mode of delivery was so open and quite creative that it would draw me in, and it would allow me to learn.
Allowing people to critically reflect away from the pressures of, you know, the next event or the next movement, conference, etc., etc. It does create a critically reflective space and a very interesting one, because the type of people who end up on the course are, by and large, very committed to social justice and equality, but they've come at that in different ways and with different experiences. So I actually think negotiating those differences is incredibly fruitful.
What I did find was the range of people's experiences, and they stretch from the anti-drugs movement to Centre for Independent Living, a myriad of things in between, some of the environmental movements, the women's movement, you know. And they were bringing all that type of experience into CEESA.
There's a wide range in age as well. There's people who had only kind of left college. There's been people around my own age, people a bit older, people from rural backgrounds, people from urban backgrounds, autonomous social centres, food politics, gender politics.
Community educators, community organisers, young people who are finding their feet in activism, ecological movements, anti-capitalist movements. So, I mean, it's quite a rich tapestry of ideas and voices.
I had no really tangible understanding of the impact that collective organising could bring. And I also didn't know a whole lot about the changes that have been made in our society by grassroots organising, or by people frustrated with their political representatives. CEESA really encouraged us to kind of look at our theoretical practices, but also our practical practices, and really reflect on the overlap between those, how each can benefit from the other, but also reflect on how we work.
It definitely developed like my confidence in my own voice and opinions and kind of how I felt about the world, and that's definitely translated to other areas of my life. I'm much more kind of forthcoming or outspoken about, you know, things I'm involved in and like how I feel about issues of equality. And also in campaigns, I've felt like the confidence to become way more involved and take on more kind of organizing roles that I never felt comfortable before speaking in groups, kind of especially around campaigns. I just felt I didn't have the experience or like some kind of level of knowledge that was required.
We're in this post-industrial society, which I'm only beginning to understand. So where is the industry in this society where you can organise like we used to organise? It doesn't exist, you know, precarious employment, people afraid to lift their heads.
At the end of the course, you know, I'm not saying all my questions are being answered, you know, like, you know, it'd be foolish to say that this, you know, ticks all the boxes and you'll go off and you'll know all the answers to every type of problem that you will encounter in your activist life. And just to look at it even more broadly, as a student going back to somewhere to learn, I think Maynooth College is really, really lovely learning environment. The facilities there, the kind of peace and quiet, the fact that it's outside Dublin really adds to the kind of atmosphere of it. The lecturers, again, by the end of it, I'd like to consider them kind of friends at this stage. They talked the talk and walked the walk. It wasn't as if, you know, they talked about some of these kind of, you know, cool ideas, and that they actually both have a background in activism, and also that's where you want to see the ideas taken from are in the course and brought out back from it. So
I mean, what we've really discovered as staff is just how much we learn from working alongside students as peers, as equals. And I think that sort of egalitarian atmosphere, that co-investigation of our shared reality has been just as powerful for staff as it has been for students. The movement for equality and justice outside the walls, it should be the key focus, and that gives the course its specific atmosphere. It gives the course its focus, and I think it's one of the things that's most powerful about it. It is focused on what we can do in the world as a whole in Irish society.